गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आई होप वी डिड लॉट मेनी चैप्टर्स, बट सीबीएसई हैज स्लैश डाउन द सिलेबस नाउ. सो नाउ वी इंटायरली नीड टू फ्रेम आवर माइंड टू डू वॉट इज कमिंग इन आवर कोर्स. सो नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स वॉट एवर चैप्टर्स विल बी डूइंग वी विल डू एज पर द सीबीएसई गाइडलाइंस गिवन टू अस, एंड वी विल एक्सक्लूड दोज पार्ट विच आर नॉट कमिंग इन द सीबीएसई एग्जामिनेशन, राइट. So when I studied all the chapters, I found out that many of the parts are eliminated, but they have kept intact the entire organic chemistry, just excluding two or three things here and there, right? So that is I find that it is most feasible to start now organic chemistry. So what we'll do is we will start with organic chemistry now, because more or less the whole part is included in your syllabus. Except two, three things which we'll be excluding when we do the chapter. Then coming to the previous videos that we made, so we studied principle and extraction of elements. That is purely eliminated. You need not study that chapter. But for your competitive exams, you have to take care. You have to study that chapter. That's important. So now today we'll be starting with haloalkanes and haloarenes. Before we start, a brief outview, a brief outlook of what the chapter is all about. So when we say organic chemistry, we mainly deal with carbon and its compounds, right? And this is a class of compound in which we have such compounds in which we attach halogen atom. So all the medicines which are very important in our day-to-day life, they mainly comprise of haloalkanes. That is why this chapter is taken as the first chapter in organic chemistry and is most important. All the basic reactions will come in this chapter. In the forthcoming chapters, we will just have a revision again and again of the same reactions. So some basic reaction is very important. You have to take care of these reactions, what we are going to study in this chapter. So haloalkanes, the word says it, it is halogen attached to alkanes. We say haloarenes. Arene means cyclic compounds, ring chain. So if a ring has a halogen atom, we will call it haloarenes. So the general formula for any alkane is this. We decrease one hydrogen, CnH2n plus 1 X. Now this X can be fluorine, it can be chlorine, it can be bromine, and it can be iodine. So anything, if you replace it by a halogen, will be known as haloalkanes, right? Coming to haloarenes, haloarenes will have a ring and a halogen attached to it, right? So we'll be dealing in detail. Now whenever we start with any chapter in organic chemistry, how we go about it? The first thing we need to know is, what is the significance of the chapter? The second thing that we will be doing is the nomenclature. How we write the nomenclature, the name, IUPAC naming of that compound. So coming to IUPAC naming, I hope you remember the rules, what we did in class 11th. But if somehow you don't remember, we'll be repeating those rules. So nothing to worry about it. Then after doing the nomenclature, we'll be doing method of preparation of those compounds. So method of preparation, all the basic reactions from which you can actually make that compound. So we'll come in method of preparation. Then we will study the physical properties of the compound. Coming to physical properties, we say how the boiling point varies, how the melting point varies, how it looks, what is the boiling point, what is the melting point, what is the difference in boiling and melting point among the isomers. All these will come in the physical properties. Then coming to chemical properties. Now coming to chemical properties, we'll be discussing about the reactions, the nature of chemical reactions, the nature of bond, the general mechanism of the reactions, how they react, and what is the polarity of carbon that is involved. So that all will come in chemical properties. Then in the last, there was a topic known as polyhalogen compounds in this chapter, but because it is now eliminated, we won't be doing the polyhalogen compounds, right? Just make sure before you start reading any chapter, whatever is important for the CBSE, you just go through the deleted portion. Don't study whatever is deleted. For CBSE, remove that portion and then study the chapter. Right? So we are coming to Hello Alkanes. Now the first thing which is important that we are going to study is the classification. Classification of haloalkanes. So when we say there is a straight chain compound and in that you have halogen attached, so we will call it as aliphatic hydrocarbon. So aliphatic means what? Aliphatic means that you have a straight chain compound and in that compound you take out one hydrogen and you put a halogen atom. So that way you will call it as aliphatic hydrocarbon. Then coming to aliphatic hydrocarbon, can be classified first based on number of halogen atom that you attach. That means what? If I have a compound like this, there is one halogen in the entire chain, we will call it as monohalogen derivative. So mono word says it that you have only one halogen. Coming to two, if you have two halogen derivative, you can call it as dihalogen derivative. So this is a dihalogen derivative. Similarly, you can have three or more. So when we say three or more, we will call it as polyhalogen derivative. That polyhalogen derivatives are now not in the syllabus, right? So this classification is based on depending on the nature of halogen atom. Now coming to this, if you have a dihalogen derivative, say if I have dihalogen derivative, I can write it two ways. I can either write it like this, C, X and X, both the halogen on the same carbon, or I can write like this, CH2, X here, CX and CH3. What is the difference? There is a halogen on two carbon, different carbon. This is a halogen on the same carbon. So we say that dihalogen derivatives can again be of two types. This type is known as geminal dihalide. We call it geminal dihalide. If I say that the halogen attached is attached to adjoining carbon, neighboring carbon atoms, in such case we will call it as vicinal dihalide. That vicinal dihalide is also known as wick, and geminal dihalide is also known as gem form. Right? So the first thing is the classification depending on how many halogen atoms you are attaching it to the carbon chain, the first thing. The second thing, if it is a dihalogen derivative, we need to see that whether the halogen is on the same carbon or it is on two adjoining carbon. If it is on adjoining carbon, we will call it as vicinal dihalide. Coming to the next. So this is all about hydrocarbon. If I say I have a double bond. If I say I have a double bond, so this is the first, then we will call it as haloalkenes. So the word alkane, alkene, alkyne, if you remember, the alkane word says it that you have a straight chain with all single bonds. Alkene word says that you have a double bond somewhere, and alkyne word says that you have a triple bond. So depending on that, haloalkene. So if my chain is like this and I attach a halogen, of course there are hydrogen by default you will add. So if you have a compound like this, so there is a double bond as well as there is a halogen atom, so we will call it as haloalkene. Coming to the third one, that is haloalkynes. Again, there is a word alkyne. Alkyne means there is a triple bond. And then the word halogen. So that means you have a halogen attached to such a chain that has a triple bond in it. So you can write like this anything. So this is a haloalkyne. So mainly three types: aliphatic hydrocarbon. Then depending on the number of halogen, it is monohalogen, dihalogen, polyhalogen. Then dihalogen can again be vicinal and geminal. And then this is haloalkenes. That means there is a double bond, and haloalkynes. That means there is a triple bond in the structure. Now coming to the next. This was aliphatic. We will do the aromatic part again. Next, number it systematically. So we have written till third. So we will just write fourth. Aromatic hydrocarbon. So we are coming to aromatic hydrocarbon. In the aromatic hydrocarbon, there are two possibilities. So you can either have this side chain derivative, or you can have nuclear aromatic hydrocarbon. So there can be two types. So nuclear aromatic hydrocarbons. And these hydrocarbons are actually haloalkanes. So sorry, I have written hydrocarbons. We will just write aromatic haloalkanes. So if I write side chain, so that means a benzene ring will have a side chain. In the side chain, you take out one hydrogen and a halogen, like this. So one possibility is like this. Okay. The next possibility is you have two halogen on this, like this. This can be the case. Or there is a possibility that you have a carbon here. We will just write the common name. You can have a possibility like this. Carbon is 2 degree. You have a methyl here and a halogen. Or you can have one possibility is this, that you have a carbon which is 3 degree and then you have a halogen, right? So they have common names, so that is why I have written these examples. They all are side chain derivatives, but the difference is the side chain which is having halogen, this carbon is 1 degree. 1 degree means the halogen is attached to such a carbon which is attached to only one more carbon atom. In this case, this carbon to which the halogen is attached is 2 degree. In this case, that carbon to which you attach the halogen is 3 degree. So depending on that, we have the name. This is known as benzyl halide. This is common name. So remember, this is common name. So this is benzo. Benzo halide, and this is benzyl, benzyl, and benzo. Benzo halide. They're all common names. So depending on whatever halide you have attached, you'll be writing the name. So they are all side chain derivatives. 1 degree benzyl word, side, this is common name. 2 degree benzyl, 3 degree is benzo. They all are side chain derivatives. Coming to nuclear, when we say nuclear, our benzene ring is straight away attached to halogen. This halogen can either be fluorine, it can be either a chlorine atom or bromine atom or iodine atom, right? So aromatic haloalkanes are mainly classified into two groups. You have side chain derivatives and you have nuclear derivatives. And then we'll be discussing about the IUPAC name. This is just general or common way of writing the names, right? So just we'll keep it there. Then we will come to the next classification. This is fourth. So we'll come to the fifth. In a straight chain, you can also have another classification depending on degree of carbon atom.
degree of carbon atom. That means what? We have to see the degree of that carbon which is attached to the halogen atom. So our halogen haloalkane can be a primary haloalkane like this. It can be, this is 1 degree primary. Our haloalkane, then why it is important to know the degree of haloalkane? It is because this degree will further affect the reactivity of these compounds. So that is very important. We should understand that they have a general mechanism of reacting. So if you don't know which is more reactive, which is less reactive, it becomes very difficult to decide the reactivity. So that will come in the chemical properties. So we will just read this 1 degree. If you have to write 2 degrees, 2 more carbon atoms, and this carbon is attached to halogen, so this is 2 degrees, second degree. And then comes tertiary would be, or 3. So depending on the degree of carbon atom, what you can have? You can have a primary haloalkane, you can have a secondary haloalkane, you can have a tertiary haloalkane. So that is depending on the degree of carbon to which you attach the halogen atom. Then coming the next one, you have 2 more things which are very important depending on allylic and vinylic group. That would be the 6th one. Depending on allylic and vinylic group. Now, if we recall allylic carbon and vinylic carbon. So, if you recall, allylic carbon is 1 carbon ahead of a double bond, right? So this will be like this. If this carbon is attached to a halogen, so this is an allylic group, so this is a allylic. Talking of vinylic group and vinylic halide, so vinylic group we can write like this. This carbon, that means the carbon which is attached to the double bond, is attached to a halogen. So we call it as vinylic line. So that is the difference. So there are 2 more classifications depending on the allylic and vinylic groups. We can further classify the haloalkanes which are present in straight chain. Coming to the next, benzylic we have already done, and then we have done benzylic side chain and nuclear groups that we have done. Now coming to aryl halides. The next would be 7th one. 7th one is allylic aryl halides. Aryl halides will be all those halides which have some other group and a halogen. Some other group and a halogen. So we will call it as aryl halides because they all will have a benzene ring in that. So depending on all the classifications, so you can now identify whether it is an aliphatic haloalkane, it's an aromatic haloalkane. If it is aliphatic haloalkane, you have to see based on number of halogen atoms. You can have 3 types, mono, dihalogen and polyhalogen. Then you can have allylic and vinylic depending on a double bond or a triple bond. If it is an aromatic haloalkane, aromatic haloarene I should say, then it can be either a side chain derivative or it can be a nuclear derivative. So the classification are these many. To just practice the classification, now we will come to the nomenclature. The nomenclature of haloalkanes and haloarenes. So the nomenclature rules are very common. I'll just tell you briefly the rules. Then from the book, I'll give you some numericals, some naming which you'll do on your own. So the basic rule says that whenever we write the name, say this is a carbon chain and this is a halogen attached, what you have to do is you have to just number the straight chain And whenever you number the straight chain, you have to decide the position for this. So like this 1, 2 and 3. So this is a propane. And this halogen, say it is a chlorine group. So on second you have chlorine, so it will be 2 chloropropane. Right, so that is the basic rule of naming. So what we do, and this is always written as prefix, that you have to remember. For halogen, we never write it as suffix. We will always write it as prefix. So you need not worry. Anything that comes in this name will should not bother you. You will always write the halogen name as prefix. Right? So depending on that, we will just try out few questions quickly. If all of them are correct, then we can move on. So just few nomenclature questions. So I'll just write the questions. You try naming on your own. So let me see. I'm giving you some examples. So we'll be just writing the naming one by one. CH3, CH, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH. Right? Then you have CH3, C, CH3, you have Cl, then CH2, then CH3. Okay. Then you have C, CH3, 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 and Cl. Okay. That is it. And then one more we will just write. CH3, CH, CH2, Cl, CH3. Right? Okay. Let's see the naming for all these. These are simple ones. Then we'll move to aromatic. Coming to this first one. You have to give, start the naming. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the naming would be 3-methyl. Now one thing which we have to remember is, we go in alphabetical order. So this will be 1-chloro-3-methyl. The number is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. Coming to this. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you have 2-chloro-2-methyl. 4 again. Butane. Right? Coming to this, you have a chain like this, 1, 2 and 3, I think it's the same. So it is a propane, so 2-chloro-2-methyl and the name would be propane. Now this common name can be isobutyl chloride. But if you have to write the IUPAC name, IUPAC name, so you will write like this. It will be 1-chloro-2-methyl and propane. So I hope this rule you know it already. So I hope you know this rule, and then you can practice more nomenclature from different books. Be confident about it, because there's nothing technical in this. We have already done the rule, right? Coming to the nomenclature of aromatic ones, so we will just do that also. We will just write few compounds and name it aromatic. If you have to name it. Say I have a compound like this. You have CH3 and then you have a Cl here, right? Then you have something like this. Cl here and then CH3. Okay. So if you have something like this, so what we do? We will always write the name as, you can write it as toluene also, or you can write like this also. 1-chloro, number is nearer, this is 2. 2-methylbenzene. instead of methyl benzene you can also write toluene, 1-chlorotoluene can also be the name, 1, 2, and 3. So you can write 1-chloro, 3-methyl. So that would be the rule.
So what you will do is name the halogen always as prefix and then write in continuation the name of the main parent group that you have written, right? Now we have to come to the second part of the chapter, that is we have to discuss about the reactivity, we have to discuss about the physical properties and the chemical properties. So just we will discuss briefly the nature, how is the bond, then we will move in the next class about the properties, physical and chemical properties, right? So coming to the nature of this bond, if you talk of this bond CX, so if you remember inductive effect, in inductive effect we already read that this will pull the electrons, this will develop partial negative, this will develop partial positive. That means what? That the carbon has a partial positive charge. That means the nucleophile can come and get attached to this carbon, and then you have removal of this X and the reaction can take place. So because of this partial charges, this is a partial covalent bond, there will be chemical reactivity is moderate, neither too high neither too low for haloalkanes, and haloarenes will show resonance stabilization. That is why it's difficult for them to react, because they are resonance stabilized. So we will see that the haloalkanes are more reactive than haloarenes. That is because of the partial charges present in the CX bond. So that we will see when we will study the chemical properties and the physical properties. For the time being, you practice the nomenclature, the type of classification, so that you are confident about it. In the next class, we'll be starting. And it is very, very interesting and very important. All the basic reactions will come in this chapter. So make sure you learn them in the first chapter so that you can again and again correlate. Right?